CC4 speech, Grandma's White Lies. Madeline? Angelic godmother smile. My dear grandchild, you look so beautiful. But you will look more beautiful, like Pocahontas, if you cut your hair just a little bit shorter. Being the youngest grandchild at that time, not just because she was the apple of my eye, also because the fact that I want to be as beautiful like Pocahontas, of course I would agree to her lightheartedly. And I remember she was very pleased with me agreeing to her, and so she drove me to her favorite salon where her friends were the hairdressers. With her white, old white kitchen car, I remember that. I would held her hand gracefully and full of hopes as we arrived at the salon. Her friends would greet me with a shiny bright smile. And as I sat on a stool, on a big chair, my grandmother would say, "Okay, just cut her hair short." And then her friend, which is the hairdresser, which was the hairdresser, would ask, "You mean like this?" Grandmother would say, "No, like this." It was shorter than I expected. I have no idea where does the idea of Pocahontas having short hair coming from, but as soon as my hair was being chopped off, I cried so hard that my eyes swelled shut.
Aww.
My voice could be heard echoing across the room of the salon, and that was the first and the last time I would believe in her first white lie, which is transforming me into beautiful Pocahontas. As my grandmother realized that I did not believe in her first white lie anymore, she got a quick wit in creating a second one. She said to me, "If you grow your hair long, the root of your hair will suck the blood out from the veins of your head."
Oh my God.
And then you will have no nutrients for yourself. You will become like a witch. Skinny, ugly.
That's so scary.
As a child who believed in superstition and was underweight, I was terrified. Imagine your hair sucking your blood right now, Pranita. Crazy. Despite the fact that I do love having long long hair and there were roller coasters of emotions going on, I decided to put my shield down and surrender with a plastic smile. So I cut my hair short. And boy, I believe in this white lie for a very long time until I went into university life. That was when I saw there were many girls with long hair. They were not as skinny as sticks. In fact, some of them were Santa Claus size.
Oh, that's so funny.
I was very puzzled by what I saw. And that was when I realized my grandmother liked me again. Mm-hmm. So you guessed it. I decided to grow my hair longer again. And as my grandmother realized this, she created a third white lie. She did not give up. She said to me, if you grow your hair long, your hair will actually carry a bad luck. Mm-hmm. And so what you need to do is you need to cut your hair short so that you won't have the bad luck. Ladies and gentlemen, by the time she introduced me to the third white lie, it was the time when I already entered university. This was just a time where there were a lot of roller coasters happening. And there were some times where I was left high and dry. And so I thought, well, maybe if I cut my hair short, I will have a better luck. Despite the nonsense that my grandmother told me, I decided to keep my hair short. It was low maintenance anyway. So, who knows? If I cut my hair short, I'll have better luck. And perhaps my life would be better in some mysterious ways. But as for that, I will leave all of that to further stories. Back to you.